The David Pakman Show at davidpakman.com.
Make sure to sign up for membership at davidpakman.com/membership. It'll also get you 10 entries into our iPad giveaway, Lewis. Look at this thing. This thing is just incredible.
It's amazing.
And we're going to be giving this thing away on December 22nd. Of course, you get the commercial-free podcast, archive of the show, the bonus show produced by the one and only producer, Lewis Motamedi, and plenty of other great member benefits. NASA's Kepler has confirmed its first habitable planet. This is another step towards finding Earth-like planets that may hold life. NASA said that the Kepler Space Telescope confirmed the first planet in a habitable zone outside of our solar system. French astronomers confirmed that the first exoplanet that meets the requirements for sustaining life has been found. And this is the first that the U.S. space agency, NASA, has been able to confirm. This is Kepler 22b. Is that what you would call it, Lewis, 22b? Or would you call it something like from one of the video games, like, I don't know, Orlock 16?
I would call it like Lutania or something. something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
It would be named after me.
Right.
Is what I'm saying.
So this is now good confirmation that this planet has, it's about 2.4 times the size of Earth. Its year of solar orbit, orbiting around the sun, takes 290 days, and it's about 600 light years away. So unlikely we'll be able to get there. And scientists don't know, actually, if this is a rocky planet, if it's liquid, if it's a gas planet. We don't know that yet. They've also announced that they've uncovered about 1,000 more potential planets, twice the number they've previously been tracking, that potentially could be Earth-like. From what I read, the temperature would be around 72 degrees on this planet based on its distance from the sun, atmosphere, and taking into consideration all the factors. I think that this is fascinating stuff.
I mean, I don't think it is because...
Oh, boy.
I don't think it's as fascinating as a lot of other people think it is.
Like me, for example.
Strictly because it's pretty much impossible to get there for us.
Right.
So, I mean, if we can't get there, what good is it?
So you just don't care?
Not really, no.
Let me ask you a different question.
I mean, considering the size of the universe,
yeah.
Do you know how many planets statistically are capable of supporting life?
Yeah, millions.
Yeah, so why is this a big deal?
Because we've actually found a specific one. Let me ask you a different question. It would be very, very difficult for you to make it into a certain area in the middle of Australia, in the Aboriginal area, etc. Does that mean you'd be interested? You're not interested in hearing anything about that area. If I could come up with some information about that area, that would be fascinating. You could get there, but it would take a long time. It'd be very expensive. You'd never do it. You're never going to be there in your life. You don't care about anything interesting I have to tell you about it?
It's not like that. You're talking about specific details. Maybe there's a specific...
So you don't care this
specific
planet...
Specific rock formation, specific natural occurrence.
Yeah.
A specific... People, their
Here's
their
a natural
customs,
occurrence.
Their rituals. Okay.
It's a planet, all, 72 degrees.
That's all they've got.
It has a sun and its year. Yeah, we'll go ahead.
I don't find that
Natan
interesting.
Wants to talk.
So, Lewis, if they found out that on this planet there was life, there was intelligent life, you wouldn't be interested in finding out the details of that?
I never said that. All I said was I don't think it's interesting that there's a planet that could support life that is 600 light years away.
And then how would we find out that it is supporting life if we never even get to the first step, which we've done now?
No, that's fine.
Just don't want to do it yourself.
If they can figure that out somehow, even though it's 600 light years away, that's fascinating. If there's life on that planet, if there's intelligent life, even better, we can rub it in the Bible thumpers' faces. But I just don't think it's interesting that there is a planet 600 light years away that might support life. There's no interesting details there about anything.
So, Lewis, on the fascination scale, 1 to 10, what would this be?
1 being the least fascinated.
Right.
I'd say I'm a 2.
Oh, see, I'm at like a 9 on this. Mm. 8.5, 8.6 maybe.
Well, like you said, there's millions of planets like this, so...
Right. Most of which we don't know about.
Statistically.
The other thing also about this is it's easier to use physics to destroy each other than to reach the stars. I mean, if we had explored space travel and habitat as much as we explore crowd control, LRAD, torture techniques, casual pepper spraying of people. We might be on Mars already, right? I mean, we've seen for so long now just the misallocation of resources. But you know what might actually make people more into this type of thing? Being able to exploit it for financial gain. That'll get people interested quick.
Right. I think if it were like a global joint effort,
yeah,
we would have accomplished so much more by now.
Absolutely.